I done seen it all. I done seen it all. Oh my God, I swear. Nothing new under the sun. Nobody with up with sun. I got a couple of sons, a couple of guns, a couple of chickens that bust up the party and fuck up the fun. She digging me and I'm coming to friends. She digging you while we fuck for fun. I got a suck in her thumb. That my little baby. She call me daddy like grandmama baby. If this ain't a dinner, my hand on the gravy. I've been on the craziest wave. If I'm on the stage, I think it's my minimum wage. This ain't no kennel, but hey, I'm sick of this without that bark and we sending her straight. So in a way, we the dog catchers. How many bullets your dog catcher? Sawed off, raw dog fashion. Hard off, hope dog catcher.
Police officials are drunk.
I know what they gonna say.
Potato over my gun. I'm moving silence cause niggas be clocking my funds. When they should keep eye on they shit cause baby girl coming with sun. Niggas be judging my moves, but please tell me what have you done. My cousin at air at the party for fun. Pistol grips get to squeezing. Wishing work and boy like Liam Neeson. I don't even need a reason. Loyalty over treason. Come and see me, put some respect on my name. Inside of my city I claim. I try to stay in my lane. Keep my advance and put a piece on the fangs. I'm painting for until the wheels fall. Most of these niggas probably pissed off. Who would thought I made it this far? Gold mouth. Come on.
Now these guys are active right now, right? And their 2-3 zone is a little bit different, right? There's still no excuse for having 5 turnovers in the first 4 minutes. All right, let's take care of it.
Let's go.
Hey,
go.
Hey, hey, shot goes up. We can murder them in alpha. Right? Let's clean up downhill. Let's clean up downhill.
Let's go. Let's go. Team on 3. 1, 2, 3. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
I just put diamonds on all of my teeth. Now they probably think I ain't intelligent. In the homicide unit interrogation, asking questions. You know I ain't telling. Just call me a jack all American. I'm at the top of my class with my letterman. I remember back in college, knocking on my dorm door. I ain't never let him in. Now you know that this cap, no, I hit a few. Ain't no job, I'm selling gas like I'm Jiffy Lube. I had a few, used to be squad boyfriend in class. I hear hurt from the bathroom like 10 to 2. No back and forth with these rappers. They mention me, dissing me. No talking back, I won't mention you. Watch when I come put that on your ass. I did, they gon' want me to snitch in my interview. I'm on 5, since I'm lit, but I'm really cool. Don't acknowledge the shit.
This time we're going into our 1-3-1. We gotta be aware of where 4 is at. Now that's a tough shot, that's football, right? Well, 1-3-1, no, when you're up on the front, DP, your back, your styles, your champ, you're in the middle.
Hey, boys, go, go, hey, let's have fun, let's have fun, all right? Hey, team on 3. 1, 2, 3, team, let's go.
Shot, you ain't got enough heart, get a bigger pool. Wanna fight, but he bigger, I ain't really trippin'. Reach under my shirt, grab a bigger tool. I got a Glock with a dick, let's get physical. They gon' be hollering, not ripping, they missing you. They got me started, I might as well finish. I'm from Charlotte, you know how they do, baby.
play.
Yes.
They're very, very spaced out. Now, if we have a guy sealed with numbers, let's throw the ball, right? There's been times where Andrew's been sealed, his numbers are showing, right? We have size on everyone. So that's why they're playing the zone. So we can still get post-ups from them, right? Griff, hey, let's look the screen in the zone. Let's set others up with this. Defensively, let's be solid. Alright, let's be solid. Make them contested jump. Alright, let's go.
Hey, every shot. Yeah, let's go. Be drilling and leave Bruce in their chest. Let's go.
Hey, top on three. 1, 2, 3. Four. Let's go. Hey, let's go. Let's start.
Yeah.
positioning should we keep? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, one, two, three.
Finish.
A very interesting game, right? We can chalk that up as probably our worst performance of the year. Second half, I thought that we were just a tighter unit, and I think that was even from the bench and just bench energy, even on the court. Really good job. BZ, you got anything?
Yeah, I'll just echo that. Styles, he fouled out because you frustrated him.
Yeah.
That was huge.
Yes, sir.
Andrew.
Ooh.
I pulled Andrew aside probably 6 minutes left the fourth quarter. He'd already been playing amazing. He had been doing a great job sealing down low. So he had been getting bucket after bucket after bucket, and he had none of them. And then finally, I think it might even be the next possession, Andrew seals, ball skips, he can't get a light on the layup. So
all right, fellas, we will not have practice at 5:45 tomorrow in the morning.
Yes.
Okay? So we will have, I know, that's tough, I'm sorry.
Dang it!
We will have film after school.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah.
Which might be worse.
I don't know. Have one of those Skittle smoothies for
Let's go.
After tomorrow.
Hey, Toys R Us on three. One,
One, two, three,
Toys R Us!
No,
what are your thoughts on number four?
Hey, Slater.
It's part of beating him.
Yeah, well, that was awesome.
Yeah, oh yeah,
David drew well.
This was probably one of your worst performances of the year. Would you agree?
I would.
You had 8 points off 3 of 12 for shooting, 4 turnovers, and that is just really unlike you. The team really showed that they needed you since they were struggling. How did you respond to that?
I responded by, you know, just taking a step back in my role and trying to get more people involved. Where, I mean, we saw Andy just step up, you know, take that more responsibility, scored the ball a bunch, got a bunch of offensive rebounds.
Being undefeated, you guys didn't see any way you could lose the international, I'm assuming. So when you guys started rough, did you see this as a game you needed to step up to help the team out?
Yeah, it was like halfway through the first quarter when nothing was happening at all. I feel like something needs to change, something needs to happen. So I don't know. I feel like a lot of it came just from a rebounding mindset, you know, because if I'm remembering correctly, a lot of my points came off of boards.
Yeah.
And just like hustle points and stuff like that. And there are the 3-3s as well, but.
All right, that brings me to my next question. Andy stepped up and had a double-double with 24 points. How was it to see a guy like him put up stats like that?
I mean, I'm not going to say I was surprised, because I know that Andy can do that anytime he wants. I mean, he's just skilled as a basketball player. But so it was kind of just exciting to see him go out and perform like that and carry us to a dub.
All right, what was causing you guys to struggle so much with a team like this? Because international isn't really one of the better teams you guys played last year. So why were they even in competition with you guys?
I think it was just, you know, the fact that, I mean, we were the team to beat, right? And so every team that we're going to play is just going to end up playing their best game ever. So, I mean, they came out with a bunch of energy. We didn't match it that well. So, I mean, they hit tough shots, step backs all the time, stuff like that. So, I mean, they just, I'm not gonna say it was lucky, but it was their night that night.
Everyone besides you pretty much had a horrible game. You had 24 points, 9 points were from the 3-point line, and you had 11 rebounds. So you had a double in a game. So scoring 24 in a game where nobody was playing good, how did it feel?
I'm gonna be honest, it felt pretty good. Playing on that team, I knew I wasn't like the first person to go to for points, but yeah, scoring 24 felt pretty good, but I also knew that like we kind of needed help because we weren't playing the best. Mm-hmm. And so I don't know, just trying to shoot with confidence, you know, just trying to win, because we couldn't have lost international. That would have been horrible.
Yeah, that would have been awful.
Something that made scoring easier that game was the fact that Champ, Derek, and Styles were such threats. And though they might have not been playing their best games of their lives, they're still offensive threats. So like being like behind everyone made that easier as well.
Mm-hmm. I see what you're
saying. That was my, yeah. When you have like Champ in the paint, and then Derek like being as good of a shooter as he is, and Styles like just scoring every way he can, like it makes it kind of easy to just kind of be behind everyone and just kind of board and put up shots.
So at the end of the first half, you guys were only up 2 points. What did you guys do differently in the second half to do so much better and even win by almost 20 points?
You know, stop being stupid, stop turning the ball over, and pretty much just held our ground, played better defense, went in for the offensive boards, and then Andy was just making shots. We were passing it to the open guy, playing good basketball, AAU basketball, how I like to say it.
You had a little over half of your average and double your average of turnovers. Was there something wrong mentally or just an off night for you?
It was just an off night. I mean, my shots, they were online. I thought they were going in, but I mean, they just rimmed out. And then the turnovers, I wasn't in sync with who I was passing it to. I mean, I had a couple to Evdog where he wasn't looking at the ball, so that was on me. So it was kind of just, I was just off that night, I guess.